And that almighty magic white is on that almighty canvas. In my mind, clear, clear water, beautiful waters running down the hills. I remember we go so often into the mountains, and then you'd like to drink that water, and you always think that's the most purest water ever, because the ice melts up there, and it floats down a lot of little wonderful little rivers. You put your foot in this icy cold. Oh, and then you create that piece of land where that water comes down. Let me create a kind of a runoff in the mountain, right in that almighty mountain. You see that water, just up to you now. I'm all alone, and the Lord is with me, and he said, put yourself up on the hill there in that almighty mountain, and you see no sky at all. You just see the clothes of a water coming out there and running over stones, and it's so crystal clean. Oh, it's ever nice to drink, and makes you feel so good. Usually I take some home if I have a can or something, a bottle. I bring it home, and I think, I make my coffee with that. That is the healthiest water ever. It's on your mind. But when you really look up there, sometimes a dead deer lying in there, old crow. And when you see it and say, oh, I shouldn't have told you that. Forget that end, I should not have told you that water is as clear as it comes. And that's a nice thing. Okay, good. So we will do it. Magic light is on, I would say, and not to waste any time, I will use colors first. Black, Prussian blue, Alizarin crimson. They are the main colors actually for all kinds of things he wants to do. Maybe a touch of sap green into that, and I will just create kind of a whatever's round out of that mountain. You see this kind of a leaves. And but I use that color in order to do what I want to do more. Some green and brownish and reddish and darkish. And see? So that's what I do first in order to think that out of that is the water coming out. See, you always have to space your canvas, or you have to make room for whatever he wants to do. This is the only thing I think, to me anyway. Then you can hang trees in there, coming out there, or branches in there. But then we will see. That's the beginning. Let's finish it up as good as we can. That means, with other words, I will create a kind of yellow, bit of a red stone. Leave the dark, just movements with grout. Again, firing, no mercy. That will be just beautiful. Clean a little bit. Yeah, I clean on my paper here. Just get that dirt off the brush. I don't want to lose more paint. So we fire in. Just put it alive. Then maybe in between, make it really dark color. Maybe dark somewhere really. See, maybe a bit dark there, some dark holes in between. Yeah. No, whatever you want to think, you don't see, you have to keep that mountain all in your mind, and then you are from there. So I will mix a mountain color, bit of white here, and black, passion blue, a little crimson, and mix a kind of a mountain color there, like steel, bit more black, bit more blue. So, and then I would say this just happened here. Here you see some. more white. See, maybe more dark. Just give him kind of a see, yellow, and you fire in maybe here some kind of a steep movement coming down the hill there. See? Leave that in the background. Have darker movements in the shadow, the light and shadow you apply. This is the game. That's a beautiful thing to do. See, apply with light and shadows, with dark there, with light there, here. See, maybe here I will highlight that with a bit of a sunshine color. This one, this particular one. See, now you take some, make some tree trunks standing there. See, you build it up in your own mind. That is where your artistic abilities are coming powerful. You learn to be the creator. You're next to God with all your might, with all your power. You can create whatever you think it is there. See, isn't that wonderful? Isn't that wonderful? See, that's what makes it so nice to be free on your own canvas, and therefore you really learn to do the things you want to do. What I do is only I show you idea how I would do it, and I wish you would go from there and make it your own. Become the almighty master of whatever. Not only the master, the almighty master. And then you say, look at me, with all my power, I create some wonderful things. It doesn't have to be a landscape. It can be anything you want. Anything. You can write a whole book with your paintings. See, there you are. In the mountains, it's all crooked and whatever. Just show this here a little bit, there a little bit. See, so, and then in the meantime, you fire in a little bit of sunshine like this. See, that's all just a creative. See, a little bit of sunshine hit that particular tree there. A little bit of sunshine hit that particular in the dark. Oh, that's always nice. You see, let the sun hit certain spots there. See, dim down your paint, a little bit of paint thinner in, because I can see it didn't come the way I wanted. Then you thin it down and look how nice it comes then, you see. This highlight, give them a little bit of highlight here or there, and that brings a certain spark into that paint. See, isn't that nice? That is good living. That is good living. Here and there, not everywhere, just some places where you think there's whatever. See, already it has some depth. Is she or isn't she? You don't know what the devil is going on there. Now you will say, come down here. See, that's coming down from wherever it comes from, you don't know. It is disappearing, and here, so. See, now we have to create the power, light and shadows, light and shadows. See, this is what makes the painting so nice. Then the sun hits here and hits there, and with that sunshine, you are coming with the sun, with that almighty sunshine. It just hits there a little bit. See, and all of a sudden here, it is really dancing. Can you see how wonderful it's already coming on there? See, and create it the way you want. You are next to God. You are the creator. You are the almighty creator. Maybe here I create a kind of a, you need sometime a little bit of an extra. In order to get a painting, to sell that painting, I will do certain things. See, I think it would be wonderful if I extend this here and have this coming in like this. See, against the dark, the light, can you see that? Isn't that wonderful? And then you fire in the same thing you fire in the water there. See? That is creative power. That is almighty creative power when you can do that. Look at that. Oh, isn't that nice? Isn't it ever nice? See? Then you can have a little line in between. You make a little dividing line. You can use a kind of a blue sometime. See? Here. Here, run it in a little bit. In a little bit. See, now I will use nice blue and white. Blue and white, you will see that is itchy. That makes it really nice. I put the white up here and add a little bit of blue. See, this kind, oh, that is, watch, that's a killer. That's a killer here. Can you see? A little bit blue here, a bit blue there. Oh, gee, now the water becomes water. It's blue. See, and then in the sunshine, then maybe here you have again a bit of a blue line there. Fire in like this. See? Here we will use a big brush, and I will pull that down a little bit like this, and I will make it like this. See? See? Can you see how? Ah! Oh, God, is ever nice. Isn't that ever nice? So I wish you could understand my feelings now, because you get so excited and you get so happy by doing those kind of things. Oh, let me see what I'm doing here. I pull this a bit more in here. So that's good. So that gives me a new beginning again, see? Thank the sun between all the branches and all the... There's some sunshine popping up here and there and there and there, and hits there and hits there, and then the rest is in the deep dark. And then you just whisper. See here, you just whisper. There you are. And now all of a sudden here is where is a big stone. And then here on this side, you watch this. On this side, a little bit sunshine hit somewhere, came through all the branches and leaves, and you have a little bit of sunshine there. And then you have green, a little crimson, and then you have some dark branches hanging down there. See? And here you create your water again. And here you add stones or the mountain dirt coming down there, coming down there, coming down there. See? Light and dark, sunshine, shadows. This is in the shadow again here, this whole movement. See, against this light, you have all that dark. See? It's a joy, it's fun to paint along with this. I think that's what makes big, big masters, big artists grown out of that. When you're young, I wish some young people would start this off, and as they grow, they out of that comes the power, you know. You really learn to make something just wonderful out of that. That. This colors, this colors, this colors. And then you let just a little bit of a shadow there. See, I use the top paint and run a little bit of a shadow down there into the sunshine. And that's it, that's it, that's it. See, now we can come up. Oh, lots of dark, lots of dark, lots of black. I use a big brush now, and blue, Prussian blue, Alizarin crimson, and I will have a lot of shadows. A lot of shadows there, a lot of shadows there. See? Isn't that wonderful? Wonderful. Just dark, very dark. And then in that dark, I will show you how we really get going. That makes it so nice. Yeah, I make it this dark. Without dark, there is no light. There's no light. So soon I got this dark. Then I will dance the sun in where I want. So you know, you can look into that already. That's wonderful. That is wonderful. Now here we will make kind of water movements. Water movements. Yeah, see, yellow and white. Indian yellow is the best and white. See how I take it off with my fan brush, you see? And then you just let water movements be there. See? Water movement here on this side too. The against the dark would be just perfect. Look at that. All of a sudden it comes to life. Then you step back. Always step back. You can see better then. It would be nice if I had here a little bit. You see there? Add a little bit because then you can see where you need. Well, you need a little bit of more power. Maybe here would be nice to make it really tickle there. Tickle it right there. That's where the water comes out of the stones. And then in your own mind, you create the sunshine spot there. See, in order to make it sellable, the sellability of a painting. See, you create that kind of a extra there. Maybe here a little bit. Now we get it cooking. Now we will get this going here. Get that almighty stone. kind of a mountain color I create here. And we will make it like this. See, a bit of a stonish, stone feeling on this side where the light comes from. See, there. Now the next side, the next step. See, gobble up all the paint you think. Maybe here would be nice if there's like a cliff coming down there. This is shadow side, I won't worry too much. Now here, I will show you something nice. All of a sudden from here it goes into the shadow. In the shadow side, and the water is still running, so I use white, a block of white, I put it over here again, and create a kind of a happy blue, and that happy blue from now on will take over. See, the water's running here. With the bluish tune, see? That makes it nice, look at that. That blue can be so wonderful. Blue yonder, depth, water. See here, I will create a little bit of ply, water plying against that stone. See, there, here, all of a sudden, you create a blue there. See, look at that, with the dark. See, then you can use the side of the brush, see, lots of blue and white, and sometimes watch this movements, you can go on and do it like this. See, and move it like this. Can you see? Beautiful. Make like water puddles and water going up and down, and is in the shadow. You don't have to worry about light there. Because all those trees here, okay, in order to show you the trees better, I will fire off there. See all those trees hanging down there. See, that's a dark. Dark. See, and they build an almighty shadow there. They build an almighty shadow there. More dark, more blue, more whatever. You let some branches hang right in there, down there. See, isn't that wonderful how you can, all that almighty creative power, that is really something else. That is really something else. Maybe here I'm giving other little push with cliff. There's another little cliff standing there. Stone, whatever's in the water. But it's in the shadow, you don't worry too much. I will dip into the magic white and make it a little bit thinner. And then I just dance it down, maybe here we touch it a little bit with blue and white, and here a little bit, like it goes up there. See? And here maybe make a side move. I come out from here like that. See, like the brush line, you can see the water movements there. Then you blue and white, you move around here. See, there. Beautiful. Now you see the light and shadows. This is sometimes wonderful. And if you want, you get too itchy and you say the sun, between all those trees there's an opening, and in that opening the little sunshine came through. And that little bit of sunshine I show you now. See, but that's up to you. I just show you what can be done. How is it possible? Just that little bit of sunshine can be the best seller to your painting. See, whatever you do now, you step back and say, where can I put more sun? Where it would look good? Where can I do this and this? And then now I come to the point where I just maybe shut down a bit of sunshine here a little bit, whatever. There, maybe here. See? And then you have it always in the light, in the sunshine, in the shadow. And if you want, now you can have... branches coming in, they're hanging down. See? Isn't that wonderful how you can do that? There, here, maybe hanging down a couple more, hanging down a couple more here. Here, and whatever. We see how nice you get the almighty painting together. Maybe here we give them a couple more water lines, and that is what it is. See? Now, I hope you enjoyed it. That is just the way I would express myself on a canvas like that, coming out of nothing into the sunshine, into the shadow, and the sunshine again, shadow. Did you enjoy that? It's a wonderful teaching. And I thank you for watching me. Bye-bye.